Hey guys, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion quick tip. Today, I've got a little clip for you I created last summer using my Insta 360 One X. I basically have rendered out my camera looking forward at this point. I've got all sorts of different clips going on, but I want this clip to work with just now. So what I'm going to do is just double tap anywhere on the timeline. I'm going to get rid of this little clip here, which I was mucking about with before. I'm going to start with a fresh lower clip. So we'll just actually, we don't need a lot of it just now. So I'm going to take it to just past these people, and then I'm going to do a cut. This just means I'm working with just a few seconds worth of video for the purposes of this demonstration. So again, highlight the clip, duplicate it, and then drag it on top. This gives you two video layers, the original layer underneath and then the new layer above. With this layer, we can double tap on it. That takes us into frame and fit, and we want to go down to blending. I have to say, if the guys from LumaTouch are watching, please, 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 please move blending up a little bit higher, because it's something I use and I'm pretty sure other people use a heck of a lot. And also, in the color effects, it would be quite good for the color presets and that if we had the option to blend here as well, saving us having to jump back to frame and fit all the time. Anyway, that's my little digress for today. So we're going to go into blending, and today we're going to take a look at, if I scroll down, overlay and soft light. Now, we're not actually going to use overlay, but I just want to show you the difference between the two. So overlay tends to give you punchier, more contrasty colors, but it crushes the blacks. And you can see that in this sort of hedgerow there next to the giveaway sign. And if we just play that through a little bit, you'll get the idea. Whereas soft light still gives you a punchier color, but it doesn't quite crush the blacks as much. A little bit flatter, like so, which is what you want. So if I switch off the layer, there's before, actually looks really flat now, and there's after, where you get the punchier sort of color effect. So what you can then do is you can either roll with it at 100%, that looks pretty good, I mean I'd be quite happy with that, or if you want to, you can go down to blending and you can just tweak the opacity or maybe lower it a little bit, take it down at sort of 75%, just to take the edge off it. Another technique I do, which is quite handy, is you go to the beginning of the clip, you could start the clip at 100%, drop a keyframe down here at the bottom corner, and then move through the clip and then just play with the opacity a little bit. Sometimes you can drop it, we go a wee bit further, we can raise it back up, we go towards the end, we can raise it back up again. So I sometimes use this technique to draw emphasis on specific things that are going on in the video, because the two ways of looking at whether it's a still photo or video, the thing that draws you to a subject is basically its brightness and also its color saturation. So the luminance and the hue, effectively, and how bright that hue is. So that's what we're kind of looking at here. So I tend to use this technique of effectively using a soft light to color grade, and that allows me to then apply that color grade strength using keyframes. You can see that playing back there. And it's very, very subtle, the blending between a stronger keyframe and a weaker keyframe. If I just shuffle it along to around about here, you'll see the end. But the saturation just subtly picks back up. So there you go. That's your tip for today. Using soft light, obviously generating another layer and copying, and applying the soft light and then playing with the opacity and the strength of the actual blending of the two layers using as a grade, or applying a keyframe and applying a different stage of blending depending on what part of the video you want to draw emphasis to. The things that you don't want to show off too much, you can lower the saturation, and things that you want to just give a little bit more punch to and draw the person or person watching's eye is to increase the saturation. And I'll catch you on the next one.